Right, I've titled this video, The Old Fibreglassers Back. Now, does that mean the old fibreglasser, me, is back? Depends where I put the apostrophe, yeah? Or does it mean the old fibreglasser's back? Because that's how it feels to be back. Right, all joking apart, all joking aside, I don't know if the camera's just not picking this up. I'm in the deeper section of the koi pond here, yeah? Down to its drain. Now, can you see the... Can you see that angle there? That's what's acting up on this old back of mine. Now, the kind of trick, what I learned, is get some resin out of my big bucket here, rather than use little buckets all the time, multiple buckets, yeah? Because I've got a lot of hardener going on in here to get this to set on this render without all draining down, yeah? So, there's no way I can stand a bucket on that. Look at this one. There's no way I'm standing a full bucket on that slope. So I've kind of been holding the bucket, standing like a mountain goat, you know, with my skateboarding knee injury I've had. So, you know, do the paddle rolling and everything that needs to be done, so yeah. I've not done much video on this. The DSLR is acting up. It keeps turning off seconds into recording. Something up with the memory card. So again, no video, never happened. So we'll just do a little bit of laminating just to show you what's going on. This is, honestly, this is absolute peach perfection placement for a pond, yeah? Got the customer's dining area all behind that glass there, yeah? Imagine looking into this pond at the koi carp. The old fibreglassers back. No video, it never happened. Got a photograph somewhere on my computer from many years ago, and I am doing the most impossible stretch with this roller in my hand. Ooh, these days, nah, man. Customer has been absolutely staggered by the smell of this stuff. Those patio doors there are sealed. All this is sealed and the smell's still getting in his house. He'll be gone by Christmas, I'll stay a bit up. Thank you.
anti goat. Just blend that edge in. Just blend that edge in, nice. Try and not see that. You beauty. Put a left-handed glass in as well.
Hey, you know, tomorrow when this is all tomorrow when this has all gone off, I could bring the skateboard in here, couldn't I? Break my shoulder at about 1.5 metres down the slope, do my knee about halfway along the other knee, do the back of my head on that edge there. I've not got my laminating pole, so next best thing. Can I have a little bit of resin left over, so I'm going to show you a little trick that I do in a minute. Again, just that cut edge on the glass there, just tease that out. Get rid of it. Don't want to see it. Looks unsightly. Not acceptable. Not to the old fibreglasser. Yeah, show you a little bit of a trick. Just give me a minute to roll this out. Sounds absolutely perfect. Absolutely perfect time, isn't it? Now, the next little trick, just let these walls and part slopes go down, and then I can sweep up. There's a lot of nasty dust and particles on here. So, bit of resin left over in the bottom. I don't want to waste it. Could paint it out on there, but. Now, it's a non-tissue job. I want it to look as good as possible. So, a little trick, rather than waste any resin, let's put this to some use. See if we can get that camera somewhere. Where you can. There. That now shows you the severity of this slope. So I'm standing on it. Don't get me wrong, I'm not complaining. My back's complaining. It'll be complaining tonight in that van, I tell you. So, severity of the slope. Standing on it. Part buckets mixed up, because you ain't standing a full one on a slope like that. Bit of resin left over. Non-tissue finish, call it the B finish. Want to improve on that B finish. So, we'll just hit this out. Almost, it's almost like putting another flow coat on, I suppose. It just fills that fibre pattern a little bit. It doesn't do what tissue does, but it's a kind of a halfway house. Now another reason, I suppose another reason I'm doing this, if I let that go off in here, it's going to stink. It's bad enough as it is, yeah? So I might as well put it on the walls. And it's not going to be cooking away in the bucket. Just improve that finish a little bit. Given how, I'm not going to say rough, given how much the surfaces undulate all over this job, it's definitely not a tissue job. But like I say, if we can improve the finish, then why not? Just a little trick, takes a couple of seconds, a couple of minutes, whatever. And no, this is most definitely not a, oh, he's only doing that to fill pin-offs, no way. This is just 2 450s on a cold surface. This is old school fibreglassing. Every pond used to be rendered, yeah? Always. Till 2004 when I started doing that foam. 2 450s generate some heat in your layup. If you know, you know. Right. There is just a little bit, there's a little bit left over in there now. I can live with that. There's nowhere else really to put it. So once I've got, so we started there this morning, worked my way around to about that point near the skimmer. That was one hit. That was all just done now. Plus that bit of a resin wash. That's what we'll call that, a resin wash. So all that leaves me now, once I've rested this old back of mine, measure up the floor. Continuous pieces. One, two, three, four, finish that floor there, boom, glassed. Sorry, there's no video of the flow coat being put on there, which is always the bit that people like to see as it completes the job, but there was no possible angle to put a camera in there being such a tight spot. But anyway, that's another job done, and the third one in that same town in as many years.